Welcome back to the adventure. Today we are talking about 15 practical uses for old flash drives. Apply for a job. If you are applying for a job, stand out from the crowd and showcase your creativity by including a USB flash drive with your job application that has your resume, contact information, and portfolio on it. This is an excellent way to provide examples of your work, and chances are there won't be too many other flash drives next to the stack of resumes. Make new connections. Even if you're happily employed, USB flash drives can make effective networking tools. You can hand out USB drives at events like business cards, or business cards that are also USB drives, because those exist. This is great for networking. Someone may not remember your name, but they will remember being handed a USB drive with examples of your work, presentations, articles you've written, etc. Lock and unlock your computer. Using third-party tools, you can set up an old flash drive to lock and unlock your computer, not unlike the key to the front door of your house. You can simply insert the USB drive, and Windows will sign in automatically. Strong passwords go a long way towards keeping your computer secure. However, a keylogger can still capture your password, and an intruder can gain access to your PC. With the added requirement of a USB drive being connected to your computer, having the password won't do an intruder much good. Protect your online accounts. Similar to using a USB drive to unlock your computer, you can set up USB drives as a token required for multi-factor authentication. For example, if you're logging into your Google account, the USB drive would need to be connected to the PC to successfully sign in. So even if an attacker had the password and was able to social engineer a verification code from you, they would still need the USB drive to gain access to your account. This is possibly the most secure method and highly recommended for YouTubers. Set up a password manager. The average person has around 100 passwords. That is way too many passwords to remember. So the common approach is to use the same password for most things, or a variation of the same password. Something easy to remember, and maybe even short so you can key it in quickly. The unfortunate side effect is that those passwords are not very secure. Well, how can I have a long password that includes letters, numbers, special characters, etc., is unique to one account, and something I can retain in memory? The recommended approach is to use a password manager. An old flash drive is a great candidate for the job, especially if you are already using it to lock and unlock your PC, and as a token for multi-factor authentication. Password recovery. In the event you forget your password, Windows has a built-in password recovery option. After creating the password reset drive, in the event you forget your password, insert the USB drive, click Forgot Password, and follow the on-screen instructions. Now that is a way better use for a flash drive than collecting dust or sitting in a landfill somewhere. Clean up viruses. Should your computer get hit by a virus, cleaning up the mess isn't always straightforward. The more advanced malware programs out there can take steps to make sure they're difficult to find and resistant to most common removal techniques. Some might even stop you from getting online or even getting into your PC. Load up an old USB drive with antivirus software. So, in the event your computer does get a virus, simply insert the USB drive, reboot the PC, and run the antivirus software to clean it up, quick and easy. Create a repair disk. Similarly, you can load up an old USB drive with diagnostic tools for your computer that will allow you to test your memory, partition hard drives, and much more. If something happens and you are no longer able to get into Windows, you can boot the PC from the flash drive and run the necessary tools to helpfully repair your computer. Increase the performance of your PC. With Windows Vista came a new feature called ReadyBoost. The feature allows you to use a USB drive to speed up your computer by caching files to the USB drive instead of the hard drive. This feature still exists in Windows 10 and is a great application for an old USB drive. Just insert the USB drive in your PC, set up the ReadyBoost feature, and let Windows take over. Results may vary. Explore the world of portable apps. Another great use for an old USB drive is portable apps. If you're at work or school, you may not be able to install programs on your computer, but you can use a USB drive and launch portable apps from it. And there are many, many portable apps to choose from. Create an app install drive. When setting up a new system, there are some apps you may always want to install. Using third-party software, you can set up an old USB drive with the installer packages and a launcher that will install the programs for you. This makes setting up a new system quick, easy, and no internet connection required. Virtual network computing. You can use an old USB drive to remotely access your home PC using a tool like VNC. As long as the PC you are using, public or otherwise, has an internet connection, you can safely and securely access your home PC. In case I go missing file. Set up an old USB drive as an in case I go missing file. This can include things like a recent picture of yourself, a list of places that you frequent, usernames and passwords for your social media accounts, and any other information that can help identify you, places you go, and people you interact with. In the event you ever go missing, it will give your loved ones a better shot at finding you or figuring out what may have happened. Pack for a trip. When traveling, keep your key documents with you at all times. Then you don't have to hunt around for a Wi-Fi connection or wait for a slow and expensive cellular link to work. You can set up an old USB drive with things like your itinerary, information about places you'll be visiting, and car rental agreements. You can also store pictures on it and receipts. That way you can access important documents without needing access to the internet. Sure, you are still going to have to find a computer with a USB drive at your hotel or local internet cafe, but it's certainly easier than lugging around a laptop, and you don't have the hassle and security issues of trying to type in your cloud account passwords on a public computer. If none of these uses appeal to you, consider donating old USB drives to charity before throwing them away or destroying them for an art project. The drives can be securely wiped and no data can be retrieved from them, and old USB drives are extremely helpful to students in developing countries. That's 15 practical uses for old flash drives. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.